the Harvest Money Show today, we want to talk about mushroom farming. Well, for those of you who have been into mushroom farming or know something about mushroom farming, we know that the most common variety is the oyster variety, the white one that most of us have seen or bought in the markets. But on this show today, we want to bring you something different. It has a lot of medicinal value, and it is being encouraged that those of you who want to grow mushrooms actually pick interest in this new variety, which is the Ganoderma, because it has potential to bring for you a lot of money. One flower like this will give you 140 grams, and 100 grams goes for 100,000. And this tin here can give you like 7 of these flowers. So imagine how much money you can make out of this mushroom.
By name of Omodi Saddam. Yeah, I'm working with the Prof. Bioresearch. Yeah, the CEO of Mkeng Funyans Julius. Yeah, is the owner of the company. So we have we are here at Harvest Money Expo. So we have brought this Ganoderma mushroom. Yeah, this Ganoderma mushroom, we have them at our offices. This Ganoderma is a medicinal mushroom. Yeah, we use it for medicine. We have even the product from this mushroom. And then we have, we can use at our home use, like for mushroom soup. You can drink it for like mushroom soup. It helps us when you see Chinese, they normally take this Ganoderma mushroom. Because for them they take long when we come in our the most important thing in life, when we take this mushroom, you be a strong guy. So in this mushroom, when you are weak in bones, you can take the mushroom soup, and even when you don't have appetite, you can take it. It brings appetite. Yeah, like for babies and those guys which have grown old. Yeah, it helps us. So we have the gardens, they are available, and we have the seeds. When you want to buy the garden, we have them. When you want to buy the seeds to grow your own, we have the seeds. The garden is for 5,000. Then the seed is for 2,000. Yeah. So when we have a package, we have a package, it's 1M. We give you this 100 gardens, we give you a stand and a dryer for harvesting where we are going to dry them. Yeah. So when we give you, you have to put them in the loom when the temperature is 20 to 25. Yeah. So you have to cover them, or you have to put them in the dark place. Because this mushroom, in most cases, they grow at night. Yeah, we have to put them in dark places. Then we cover them with a black cavella. Yeah, for 1 month. Yeah, for Ganoderma, we have a system of first passing through the lab. We first put that seed in the lab. We first check them before we pack. So when we pack, we give you a period of 1 week. Yeah, after putting them in lab. Yeah, either when you come, we move them, then we give you from the lab. When we give you this garden, it will not be white, as you are seeing this, because this one, it is already grown up. So we have the mycelium. The mycelium, they have to move in this garden, and it has to be changed into white. It has to change to white. So when you put them like this on your trays, then you cover them with a black cavella. So the mycelium, it will be moving, or it will be growing in the what? Inside the garden. So after 1 month, when you have checked that the mycelium, it has already grown, then we put them up. Then we start spraying. We put the water thing. We have the fertilizer, which we call water things. That's what we use for watering. We put water, like for rain water. We don't put this tap water because there is some chlorine which can damage our garden. But we can use rainwater, and we put our fertilizer, water thing, and then we spray. Yeah, one bottle cup, it will be for 1 liter. Yeah, then we spray morning and evening, every day. Because this garden, it spends 6 months for growing. Yeah, that is the duration. So it has to be brown, and even this side, it has to be brown. Down and top, it has to be brown. That's when we harvest, when it has changed to brown oil. So when we give you 100 gardens, 5 gardens, we give us 1 kilogram. So on our market, we give you, yes, I have said, we give you the market. The market is available at Profitable Research. We buy these mushrooms when you have harvested them. The kilo is for 50,000, the kilo of this garden. When after harvesting, you bring and we buy. You need 5 gardens to make a kilo. So when we give you this 100 gardens, every month you have to harvest 1 kilogram to 5 gardens. So for the oil, you have to harvest like 20-25 kilograms. So, this mushroom, it doesn't have it cannot affected with this small insects. No, this it's a medicinal and it's herbal. For this one, it doesn't take a lot of care. You cannot take a lot of care because for it it's hard, and it can be independent. You cannot take a lot of care on them. Yeah.
Welcome to the Harvest Money Show. I am your host, Jackie Achan. Now we know mushroom farming is something that is being embraced out there by so many Ugandans. Most Ugandans are into agriculture because it is the biggest employer of the Ugandans when it comes to the money-making business. So today we want to talk about mushroom farming. Well, for me, I've always known about the traditional mushrooms. When you go to the wild, you can pick, mushrooms and, have it for a meal, and they're quite tasty. But, mushroom farming has grown. Now people farm mushrooms. You don't have to go to the gardens and wait for those wild mushrooms to eat mushrooms. And today here, I've actually stumbled upon a very unique, can I call it variety of mushroom? Because I've seen white mushrooms before that are farmed. But this one is a little different. It has a brown color to it. So I'd want us to take a journey and understand more about this mushroom. What is this mushroom? What does it take for us to grow this mushroom? And is it any different from the other mushrooms? And does it come with more profits? So with us today, we have a teacher who has turned into a farmer, which is quite interesting, into this business of farming this mushroom. So let's talk to her, get to know her a bit, and then we shall dive into the mushroom business. So you're welcome to the show.
Thank you. My name is Nach Torita from Bernarda Smart Farm. Bernarda Smart Farm is on Ubsawala Road. The real place is called the Gangu. You branch off from a stage called the Kalidubi. That is where we are. I'm a graduate teacher. I taught for 8 years, then I quit and I decided to do farming. I had given it time. I knew the time was supposed to be there. And then back home, we were doing it. We were into farming. So when I looked around myself, something that I really wanted to do passionately, I chose farming. And I do it quite extensively, some bit of poultry, then the tomatoes, the vegetables, and now the mushrooms. Well, the mushroom varieties are quite many. The one that has been commonly done by farmers is oyster, which is basically edible. But we so much want to venture into the industry of wellness, and the mushrooms are so good when it comes to medicine. Well, we are doing this from the Chinese friends, and they are really grooming us into the medicinal mushrooms, and they have quite a number of them. They have lion's mane, they have shiitake, we have maitake, and this specific one that we have for this show is called Ganoderma lucidum. Ganoderma is really a unique mushroom. We've known it as a mushroom that does well in the forest. It grows on wood, and it's not easy to get the big volumes from the forest. So what we do, with the science, we mimic that environment where the Ganoderma grows. We prepare a substrate from hardwood. We crush the wood, and then we prepare where it grows. You need some small space, like a room of 10 by 10 feet could do well. It's not very fragile like the oyster. It does well in temperatures that are a little high. So you need, like oyster, you do it in a moist environment, but with Ganoderma, it can survive even when the environment is not so moist. So if you have that room, for instance, you can put something like stairs, then you stack your gardens there. You need to water it like once a day is enough, and it brings. For a lay farmer, especially the beginner, it may not be easy to prepare the spawns. So there you need someone technical to prepare for you the spawns. Then as you do it, then you gather the information it takes to prepare your own spawns. Spawns, we can say the seeds. That is in a layman's language. Yes, what we can call. Now the seed at this level, it's not visible, because when we prepare the growing medium, we put the spawns here, then we cover it, and we give it water, then we give it 2 months to blossom, as you're seeing it now. This one is about to get ready. It has something like 2 weeks to get ready.
It gets bigger than this.
Yes, it really gets bigger than this.
So how does it, you put the seed on top. We are using the layman's language. Then do you have to make holes?
Yeah, when you want it to come from top here, when you put this paper, when it comes out, it pierces this paper. With the water that you put, the paper gets soft and it comes out. Then if you want it in the sides, like this one now, yeah, when you want it in the sides, then you cut, you create an opening. You just cut, the polythene, and it creates an opening. So these ones are now just coming out. Yes, they are coming out.
How many openings can I have?
If you want many, then you create multiple openings. Yes, because when you put many, these ones don't sprout out in big numbers, but they can really become so big. Now here you can have like 2 or 3, and if you have in the sides, because it grows big, it has a size that you'll have. Now when you have like 3 or 4, that one is good to go. Yes.
How many can make a kilogram?
A kilo, it's quite a number, because this one is around 150 grams. Yes. So like 4.
This one piece.
Yeah, this one piece. We give a kilo to 4 gardens. Yeah, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, the 4 can give us a kilo, and that is good already to go. Yes.
Interesting. So we've talked about how you put the seed and then put the holes for it to grow. But how long do you have to wait for you to start harvesting and selling to the market?
After we've prepared the substrate, that is technique again. The substrate is the garden now. After preparing the garden, then we put the seeds. It takes around 2 weeks to, we call it colonize, for the seeds to get to the whole garden. That is around 2 weeks. Then when they begin coming out like this one, you will give it 2 months. No, months, yes. You really have to wait for 2 months, giving it water like once a day, then it is ready. For a Ugandan lay person like me, it could be quite expensive to buy it. That's why after learning about the health benefits of Ganoderma, we are bringing it out to the farmers so that those that are health-wise sensitive can do it for themselves. Because for the friends that I know that are selling like the powder, 100 grams of Ganoderma go at 100,000 now. That is 100 grams. That is not so cheap. And yet this garden is 10,000. So if I take the garden at 10,000 and I get the 100 grams from this garden, that means I've got the 100 grams at 10,000. Yes, that's why we are bringing it out to them to create awareness so that they can have it at home. Because it is so good for preventive means. We don't have to wait to get sick first and then we turn to the medicine. If you take it often, it can help you to live a longer, healthier life.
Do you work with nutritionists to know the benefits, how somebody can consume this so that maybe they don't overdo it and it becomes a health hazard?
Well, we've been doing quite so much with Dr. Emma Naluima, and she's encouraging us to create that generation that is conscious about what they eat, conscious about food, how food can be medicine for all of us. And these days with the internet, you just Google in Ganoderma and they'll give you all the health benefits of Ganoderma. Yes. Now, if you want to farm as a starter, you'll come to us and we'll give you what we call the spawns, all the seeds. And then if you really want to go into how you can create the seeds for yourself, then we train you how to prepare the seeds, how to make the substrate or the garden, and then how to make the seeds. A tin of seeds goes for 10,000 and it makes seven gardens.
Seven gardens. Yes. So how many are the seeds? Seven.
Well, the seeds are a little tricky. Yes. They're not like seeds.
Yeah? Yes.
Yeah, like you can't count them.
I was trying
to
get a fig. Yes.
You can't count them. Eh? They are mixed with grain. Now this is sorghum.
Yes.
So the spawns are mixed with the sorghum or millet, and then we just scoop. Then we put. So you count like seven spawns for the seven gardens, and the first tin of seeds is done. One can give around 100-150, like the first harvest, because this is now the first harvest. Mm? Now when you remove this and you continue giving it water, it will bring another harvest. So four gardens will give you a kilo of Ganoderma. Yes.
So you can, after you've harvested, it can grow again.
Yes, it grows again.
How many times does that happen before
two,
you discard?
Two is good to go.
Two times.
Yes.
Then you have to discard, and then you get...
Like now for us, we don't discard. We use this kind of waste now. We mix it in the soil, and now we grow other crops like the tomatoes and the vegetables, so we don't just throw it away. Yes.
It has a nutritional
value. We mix in the soil, then we grow other crops. We are so much focusing on this urban farmer. The space is not so big, but she's passionate about farming. If you have a room of around 10 by 10, that one can make a very good garden for you. Like you put the stakes like this, you place your gardens there, first level, second level, third level, it can really do very good business. Yeah, even when the space is not so big.
I can put it in my veranda or compound?
As long as it's not open sunshine. Eh? Yeah, the temperatures are a little, but there is a roof up. Yeah, it can make a very good garden. It can be a veranda, it can be somewhere, but as long as there is a roof up, it can do a very good
it
garden.
It can't be in direct sunlight.
Not really. In as much as it has vitamin D, which is so good, we would advise it is in the shelter. It is in the shelter and somewhere locable. Because for anyone who has visited the Cancer Institute in Mlago knows what is there. We are trying to advise them not to wait to get sick. If there is food that can act as medicine, if there is food that we can eat on a daily basis, before we fall sick, that's why we are calling them to get to this industry. Yes, to get to this industry, to consume them, to teach their kids to consume them, to appreciate them before we get sick.
How about the money aspect?
The money aspect, because what is happening right now, it is the supply that is not there. Actually, if 100 grams cost 100,000, surely the supply is still so low, it is not there. So we are encouraging them to come up. If the supply is really big, we can even go for export. But the supply is not actually there. We are just beginning. Actually, we are just beginning the mushroom industry because in the previous days, we only knew oyster. It's like it was the only variety of mushrooms, and yet there are so many. Yes. Yes.
Well, you have heard it from Nachi Toshi, a former teacher turned urban farmer. She's also, you know, she's also a teacher. Despite turning a farmer, she's teaching farmers how to grow mushrooms. And now, like she said, for this type of mushroom, there is still plenty of room for you to join and be a farmer. Grow these mushrooms and be able to make money from just one of these. You can get like 400,000. There is a plenty of opportunity for you to make money out of mushroom farming. So that is it from me, Jackie Chan. Until next time, goodbye.